Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Now we will discuss the 14th chapter of The Prisoner of Zenda, A Night Outside the Castle. Dear student, in previous chapter we discussed that the Rassendyll got all important information from John about the castle, that where the king is kept and how the people are guarding the king and how is their security plan. So he had got all the necessary and very important information from the John. And we also know that the Rassendyll was injured by Rupert. He has got some serious injury on his left shoulder. And in the beginning of this chapter, the chapter starts with the report, that the report was published that the king was injured when he was playing some sports. So that news created some excitement in the public. And the marshal also got some information from the king that how his health is. And more importantly, when that report was brought to Princess Filavia, she decided that she will go and she will meet the king in person. Though we have discussed in previous chapters that Rassendyll had told her that she must not go out of her palace without full security, and or until she is fully guarded. But she decided that the king is in danger, he is injured and his life is in danger, so she decided that she will go and she will meet the king in person. So she decided to go there, and she came to Rassendyll, and Rassendyll says that when he saw Princess Filavia, and he said that her presence was like a taste of heaven for a damned soul. He was happy to see her, and he said that she again spent 2 days with him, and Princess Filavia was also happy to see that the king is okay and he's doing well and his health is getting better. So she was also relaxed to see the king. After that, now Rassendyll tells that he decided now he will take some speedy action to get the king back, because the John has also informed the Rassendyll that the health of the king was also getting dangerous. And he said that even if they do not kill the king will die himself in the confinement of that cellar, because his health was declining. And he said that the wasting time was like, you know, the giving death to the original king. So he decided for some speedy action. And he said on the next night, he left Princess Filavia in her room. Then he decided to go and visit the castle of Black Michael. And when Rassendyll just reached the bank of that river, then the companions of Black Michael also chased them, and they started fighting, they shooting each other. And there was again another fight. But the other companions of Rassendyll, who were around a quarter mile from the castle, they also joined them, and there was a serious fighting between the two parties. And somehow the Rassendyll and his companions, they survived and they went back. But in this fight, two of the six commanders of Black Michael were killed. Remember, it was the Crustin and Langram. They both were killed in this fight. Now the Black Michael was left with four special companions or commanders. Two of his special companions were killed in this fight. Dear student, this is all which is discussed in chapter number 14. Now we can question about the Rassendyll, that when he was near the pipe, when he was near the Jacob's ladder, he should have gone inside and he should have brought the king back. Perhaps this was a very good chance for Rassendyll to get the king back, but he said that he didn't do anything that night. Now what will happen in next chapter, very soon we will discuss it. Thank you very much for watching this, dear students. We will meet soon in next video. Till then, goodbye. So the Rassendyll met the party of six persons, Rassendyll himself, Sept, Fritz, and three other companions. And he said that I changed my clothes, and he took the knife and the coil of rope and all necessary things, and they started traveling toward the castle of Black Michael. And he says it was stormy and the dark night and the wind was blowing. And actually he said that weather helped them that the people will stay at their homes and they will not come out at the night. So they started traveling towards the castle of the Zenda, the castle of the Black Michael. And he said after the traveling of 1 hour, they reached near the moat. We have already discussed this moat, that is a river outside the castle of the Zenda where the pipe was fitted, the Jacob's ladder we have already discussed in previous chapter. So when they were about a quarter a mile from the castle of the Zenda, then Rasendal asked his three companions, the commanders that they were with him, that they must stay there with their horses, and the Rasendal feeds and sept, they will go near the moat. And the septes got a whistle, and when any danger came, the other three, they will rush and they will join their party. So they reach the moat, they outside the river, and the Rasendal says that the sept tied the rope on the bank. There was a tree, then he went inside the water. And he says that it was a very dark night. He could hardly see 3 yards in front of him, and he slowly swimming across the moat he went. And he says according to the knowledge or the information shared by the John, he was near the Jacob's ladder. And when he reached there, he saw that yes, there was a pipe that was curving down from window to the water. And when he was observing that, and when he was just there, then he realized a sound or some movement behind him. And when he looked there, he found a boat, and there was a boat in the river. And he was shocked and he was worried that someone was there in the boat with a rifle. Then slowly he came near the boat and he saw that the Maxov was there. And luckily Maxov was sleeping and his rifle was just lying behind besides him. Then what he did, he took his knife and he killed the Maxov. Rasendal says whether it was good or not, but for the sake of the life of the king he did it. Remember the dear student, that Maxov was the brother of the John, and the John has given all important information to Rasendal. And unfortunate for the John that with that information his own brother was murdered by Rasendal. But he says that in war everything is allowed, and for the sake of the life of the king and for the sake of the kingdom of the Ruritania, he did it and he killed the brother of the Maxov, brother of the John. In fact, the Maxov himself was killed. Then again he went near that pipe, and he heard some voice inside the room, and there was a little light, and he realized that someone was talking to the king. Perhaps he said it was the Datchet who was talking to the king, and the king was saying to Datchet that he must convey a message to Black Michael that he must kill him soon because he is dying every moment inside that confinement, inside that cellar. But the Datchet said that soon you will find a way to heaven. It means the soon he will be killed, then the Black Michael will get the kingdom. And Rasendal says that when he was staying there near the pipe, he had no courage to go inside, and he did nothing more on that night. And he decided to go back and come with some strong planning to get the king back. And when he was going back, then he realized there was some light from the castle, and someone was calling the Maxov. And when he did not answer, and the Rasendal realized that someone had started chasing him, then he rushed to the bank. And when he reached there, the sept and fears, they were already waiting there, and taking the help of that rope, he went outside the river, outside that moat.